Hi, I'm Neil Smith. I'm a music education professor at Millikan University. I'm going to be going over today the IMEA Junior High Band audition music for French horn this year. And I want to point out just a few things about the piece, and then I'll play it for you all the way through. First of all, it's a key signature. There's three flats, so it's E flat major for the French horn. And the main note you're probably going to want to look at is A flat. That's two and three. And if you have a double horn, you can use trigger in A flat to get that note. And also E flat, which is second valve, both for both octaves. If you have a double horn, first valve and the trigger will work for the E flat up there. And then later on in the piece, you'll notice that it adds an A natural. So make sure you're aware of where you're supposed to play an A flat, two and three, or A natural, one and two. And then secondly, the tempo should move along pretty quickly. It's giocoso, means joyfully. And so it should have a pretty brisk tempo to it. And you want to keep that tempo all the way throughout. And then another thing is the articulation. He's very specific about whether he wants the notes to be separated or to be slurred together. You'll look, for example, the first two measures, those eighth notes are all separated and they should be nice and light and distinct. And then slurred for the third measure as one group, and then fourth measure, the quarter note and the two eighths should be slurred together. So just look through and make sure you're really aware of what notes should be separated and what notes should be slurred. And then one last thing I would say is that the separated notes, the eighth notes, for example, should be real distinct and clear. And one of the things French horn players sometimes do is they're a little hesitant to really play a note distinctly. They're afraid they're going to miss it or it's going to be unclear. But be real brave and just hit those notes nice and clearly, and that'll make this piece really work. And I'd say overall, just use a nice, good, well-supported sound. For example, in the third line there, you're going up to that E-flat. You want to make sure you get a good deep breath there and that you're supporting that E-flat so it really lifts out. Let me play just for an example for you. So I'll start at the end of the second line into the third line. So just really support that. And it's forte all the way through from the beginning to the end. So don't let the volume back off at all. All right, here you go. Here's the audition etude for French horn. There you go. Good luck with your audition.